industry have warned that the next global financial crisis may be caused by cyber crimes, and as such, for banks to survive the shock, they must take actions today to guarantee survival and competitiveness tomorrow. A former CIBN president, Dr. Segun Aino, who led other speakers, noted that while internet and technology-based sources of fraud accounted for 59% of fraud cases and 43% of actual loss, cybercrime will cost the world $6 trillion annually by 2021 from $3 trillion in 2015. Aino warned that most regulators and operators may not be prepared for the imminent shock, as governments would not be able to provide bailouts to banks like it did previously. In their remarks, the president of CIBN, Dr. Uche Olowu, and the chairman, Lagos chapter of the body, Peter Ashade, stated that Nigeria requires an integrated, all-inclusive private-public approach to fast-tracking implementation of the digital government initiatives and programs to be able to harness the potential of the digital revolution. They submitted the cybercrime remains the biggest threat to all banks in the digital age, as digital increases the susceptibility to cyber crimes and huge losses due to cyber fraud.
We, as a nation, must realize this and have all the infrastructure and the requirements to be able to address this. Players and operators, regulators and so on also have a role to play to ensure that we have you can never really have a watertight security agreement, but we have to identify these risks and prepare for them and mitigate them so that they will not crystallize, or when there are attempts, we have enough security network to be able to address it. Otherwise, we may be in very, very serious crisis.
The message to the customer is that they are in for a good thing, because what happens is that when there is competition, there is disruption. It's designed to relieve their pain points. So banks and fintechs will collaborate together to ensure that the customers get good service. So to that extent, the customers are better off for it. And it also will facilitate financial inclusion, which fosters, creation of economic activities that foster employment and development, growth and development in the economy.
Financial sector, which banking play a very pivotal role there, is very key in any economy. So we cannot but discuss issues that affect the growth, the development, the reformation that we see in the banking industry. So for us, the team for this year's Bankers and Stakeholders Night is what app. Why? Because it's giving us that the future of banking is really great. Whereas the players, both the players and the user of banking services, must be ready to take up the challenges that is going to come as a result of the changes that we're going to experience in the market.
You're still watching MIT.